My name is Shivam Jain.
Hi, I'm Satish. How many of you thinking about your tomorrow's breakfast? Currently, for tomorrow's breakfast. I think none of you. But I want to ask one question. That's the one delicious breakfast for tomorrow's in your mind. Can you answer one by one? One by one. Yeah. That's everyone has a different. Someone likes poha, someone likes samosa, someone likes paratha. But we have one delicious food for you. That's for the girls also. There is one product in this company. That's you can be in a shape or be a fit and energized like this. So can you guess our topic? Kelloggs. Yeah. Egg. Right.
That's Kelloggs.
Yeah. Our topic is just.
Okay.
Fine. Our topic is Kellogg's cornflakes in India. How they entered in India, and finding a platform that connects to India from US.
Fine. Yeah. The objective is we selected this topic because this company has gone through a roller coaster ride because it was at a top in the US, UK first. Then when it switched to India, it had a fall down in its sales, and then when it marketed after a good research, then again the sales went up and the company was in profit. That was our objective of selecting this topic. So the contents that we are going through in this slide are introduction, products, Kellogg's entry in India, reason of initial failure and product extension, strategy that they used to move ahead, market share, the SWOT analysis, their future approach, and the conclusion part.
Starting with an introduction, Kellogg's is a leading worldwide brand for the cereals category in a breakfast, that's the FMCG industry. So it is established in 1906 in the US. That's the founder is Mr. Will Kellogg's. Headquarters situated in a Battle Creek, Michigan, US. Current CEO is Steve Chavlin, and the number of employees in all over the world are the 31,000. Kellogg's manufactured in 18 countries and offer them in more than 180 countries in the worldwide. Category-wise, Kellogg's products. The Tasty Starts, that's the Kellogg's Cornflakes and Kellogg's Crunchy Nuts. Simply Wholesome, Kellogg's Fruit and Fiber. Shape Management, that's the special for the girls. Kellogg's Special K. Mom Approved, that's the Kellogg's Wheat Flax. Kids Preferred, Kellogg's Frosties, Kellogg's Chocos, and Kellogg's Honey Loops. And so for the adults people, there is a one category, that's the inner health for digestion. That's the Kellogg's All Bran and Kellogg's Heart to Heart Oats.
Yes. The Kellogg's entry in India. So when they entered India, the normally people like us, usually in our breakfast, we use idli, vada and normal pohas and everything. But to switch these peoples to Kellogg's cornflakes was a very tough task for, you know, Kellogg's. So during their initial days, they had to struggle through the many things. Like they had to do some market research on very basic things, and market research on the human behavior, how they interact with, how they actually think, what they actually need in the morning as well as do they feel full after eating their breakfast. So these all things had to be analyzed before, which was the major reason of the fall. And they entered India by a capital of 206 crores in the beginning. The products that they initially launched in India were the cornflakes, wheat flakes, and the rice flakes. These were the products that they initially used, and the competition was against the, as I mentioned, pohas, idli, vadas, and the other breakfast cereals used?
The reasons after entering in India in 1994, the reasons that the initial the failure. The initial there was an initial impressive purchase, but this was the only one-time purchase. After a few excitement over off in India, the purchase was very few. And the factors for this initial failure in India, that's are the cultural factors and the eating habits of Indians. That's they prefer only the traditional foods, and the price sensitive customers in India, they are very price sensitive in 1994. After this, the low awareness about the processed food. People are not aware about the nutritional values in those days. In a survey, they said that homemaker survey. So we are prepared by ourselves and our family is healthy with the traditional food. They are saying that like this. So the low awareness about the processed food, easy availability of the low price traditional breakfast. Next.
Yes. So initially when they were not following the 4 P's introduced by updated by McCarthy, they were in a stage during 1995 where they were going through many hurdles basically. So they introduced new product concepts in India because of which the people were unable to connect fast, and they had less variety of products. As I mentioned, it had only 3 products initially, and they were all not Indianized. So the other thing was the price, as my friend Satish mentioned, that Indians required less price in all the breakfast. The food was also not localized, so it was hard to be managed by Indian people, and the ad they used was also not connecting to people. So when they used the 4 P's of McCarthy, they gradually increased, because in 1997, which increased their sales up to 17%, the 4 P's of they used were the product segmentation, means as in the second slide we mentioned the product categories that they improvised themselves, the price penetration, the price that they reduced according to the product that they used, nationalized products they used, whereas the better advertising strategy they used with various slogans.
Product extension after the 1970, the 4 P's model they used, that's the Kellogg Chokers entered in India, that's in 1996, Kellogg's Frosties, and after this 1998 they launched a Maza product, but they failed in that. After this one of the product in 1999, Iron Shakti Cornflakes positioned on the nutritional value, and the sales is increased by the 17%. With that, they emphasized on the nutritional values, so the sales increased by the 17%. And in 2008, the Special K for weight management targeted as a woman. Promotion strategies, they promoted like in a school, as like a sampling exercise for customers. They 25 crores they spend on in media, and launches Diwali gifts packs for the kids, and they distributed free samples and stickers like the glittering stickers for the kids. Next.
So let's watch a video by how motivating
never compromise. ये मैंने साक्षी से सीखा है. इसलिए हर सुबह टाइम कितना भी कम हो, उसके नरिशमेंट में आई नेवर कॉम्प्रोमाइज. केलॉग्स कॉर्नफ्लेक्स का नाश्ता विद आयरन शक्ति, मिनटों में खाओ, 3 घंटों बाद भी एनर्जी पाओ. ऐसा सूरज बन जिसको है ढलना नहीं. सुबह के नरिशमेंट में नो कॉम्प्रोमाइज, केलॉग्स.
थैंक यू.
Market share in India, that's the Kellogg's. Kellogg's shared a 55.8% in India. After this, the PepsiCo India 9% and Marico and Barry India Limited.
The SWOT analysis, their strengths were basically the monetary money that they brought from the US and the products. Opportunities they had were to enter in the untapped markets. Weakness was that they had to connect with the cultural habits of India, and the threats that they faced was the price.
Future approach for